Good morning, Shemstars. Welcome to class. Hope you all are fine. Today we will continue with our chapter number 5, that is Indian Sociologist. And in today's class, we discuss about M.N. Srinivas. M.N. Srinivas is popularly known as the sociologist of the post-independence era. The best known Indian sociologist, M.N. Srinivas, earned 2 doctoral degrees, one from Bombay University and other from Oxford University. Srinivas was a student of Gurez at Bombay. Srinivas' intellectual orientation was transformed by the years he spent at the Department of Social Anthropology in Oxford. Srinivas' doctoral dissertation was published as Religion and Society Among the Cogs of South India. This book established Srinivas' international reputation with its detailed ethnographic application of the structural functional perspective dominant in British social anthropology. He worked on other themes also, like caste, modernization, and process of social change. Now we talk about the advantages of village study, as M.N. Srinivas favored to take Indian villages as a subject of sociological research because village society remained a lifelong focus of interest for him. His writings were of 2 types. First of all, there were ethnographic accounts of fieldwork done in villages or discussion of such accounts. A second kind of writing includes historical and conceptual discussion about the Indian village as a unit of social analysis. Srinivas believed that the village was a relevant social entity. Historical evidence showed that villages had served as a unifying identity, and that village unity was quite significant in rural social life. Srinivas criticized the British administrators, anthropologists, who had put forward a picture of the Indian village as unchanging, self-sufficient, little republics. Villages were never self-sufficient and had been involved in various kind of economic, social, and political relationships. Some important findings regarding the village were that agriculture was the main source of livelihood. As in the villages, everyone's life centered around agricultural activity. It is the main source of livelihood for the people. Second, we can say caste system. The villages are multi-caste in composition. There are 4 main castes that exist among the Hindus, that is Brahmin, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. The next feature of village, according to M.N. Srinivas, is inter-caste relationship. In the villages, there exists a certain kind of relationship among the members of different caste group. Next is hierarchical system. There exists some kind of hierarchical order among the caste group in the village. The Brahmin are placed on the top and the Shudras at the bottom. Then division of labor on the basis of sex. The division of labor in the villages is based upon sex differences. The women handle the kitchen, their life centered around the kitchen and other household activities. The men are involved in other occupation outside the house. Next, we talk about Srinivas on the changing village. Srinivas considered the village as a social entity. He criticized the British scholars who had projected the picture of Indian villages unchanging and self-sufficient. Srinivas found that after independence, the Indian villages experienced a number of changes. Major changes were noticed at the level of technological change, economic change, political change, cultural change, and Sanskritization. The process of Sanskritization is also visible in the villages, whereby the lower caste groups are adopting the culture and lifestyle of the higher caste and trying to improve their social status. Thank you, Shemstars. That's all for today. You can drop your queries on the Google Classroom. Take care.